option, view everyone, right, sir?
One second. Okay, sorry, my daughter's online class is going on. She is came here for some doubts, okay? Sorry for that. Okay, so coming to the demo.
On the top of the screen, we see view everyone. If you hide everyone, then you can make the screen bigger. And that applies for each one of whoever wants to view a bigger screen has to do that, sir.
Can I close this or what is the way? So.
No, do not close anything, sir. Just go on top of the screen. You can see view everyone, right?
Okay, one second.
Click it and select an option of hide everyone.
Okay, select an option of hide everyone.
Yes, and Srinivas sir and Venkat sir, you will also have to do it because it's a local activity.
Yeah, I have done it. At the last icon, if you click it, the screen size will increase and the participants bar will disappear.
Yes, sir, absolutely correct. That was.
Just a moment.
And the bar is there, but okay, it's okay. We don't need that bar, right? As long as we see the presentation.
Yeah, just a moment. Okay, so, okay, I think, is that fine? Is it visible?
It is good, excellent.
Everybody has to.
So because, yeah, first time I'm using this particular tool.
I understand.
Okay, fine, so coming to the topic, so.
You can go to slide view so that, you know, entire your presentation may show us.
Okay, so how to do that, hide view?
Hide view, okay, but you want to see this slide which you want to show the warehouse layout, that is showing fully, right? Or that is the one which is showing fully?
No, I taken this function, so that is slide presentation. So in that way it is appearing.
Yes, now it is good. Now it is
okay.
Good.
Okay. So okay, fine. Maybe I need to experience on this. So maybe later I will try to investigate other points how this will work. Okay. Thanks for joining this demo session. So we introduce ourselves, and you know me, and I know you guys very well about your industrial experience. One thing I forgot to ask, so what the industry sector you guys are working in IT? Is it beverages, or are you in mechanical engineering sector or manufacturing engineering sector, or you are in pharmaceutical sector? Which sector you are working? So that is
right now we are discrete manufacturing, working on discrete manufacturing. So mainly dealing with concrete products.
Concrete products.
Products, chemical sectors. Okay,
you are in chemical sectors. Okay, fine. So where you can good. So that is the point I want to understand.
Just for additional information, since you don't restrict only to one sector, but keep it the sessions to any kind of sector, like a consumer.
Fine. So because just I'm going with the standard functionality of WM, and I'm going to highlight so what sector, how this will work, and how they are taking the subject according to their convenience. So that is I'm going to explain you in my upcoming classes. Okay, so that is the way how I'm going to take with you. So it is not only specific to sector, but the thing why I, because just I want to see from you, so what are the changes? Because I never worked on the chemical industry sector. Just I want to add, like, what is the batch, shelf expiry, some hazardous, or some of the things which are new to me. So just I want to leverage, bring those concepts in my existing class so that I can also learn with you. So this is the way what I'm thinking. So that is the way I just check with you guys.
Our present client constructions and products have this batch management. And
that we can cover that, definitely we can cover batch management, self expiry, how the behavior of the system and all. Okay, just we'll start without also, losing our time.
And also we know the integration aspects I mentioned first itself, integration with the production planning, integration with the MM, integration with quality management, most important.
Sure, that we will cover in our in the system itself. Okay, so I think any questions or something, so we can discuss also. Just it is a demo class, so I want to try to present a high level explanation on the SAP WM. So that is the point here. Okay, so this is the slide, the first slide. So just I am going to introduce about the WM. So just as a simple words, SAP. So don't go by this word. Just it is a just a kind of copy paste from the SAP contents and all. So just I want to open with you. So it is not given my own definition. So some of the things I copied from the SAP help.sap.com. Some of the taken some of the white papers and all. So it is not specific to my own content. So that is I want to very clear to you. Even though the pictures what I am showing in this screen, it is all I have taken some of the references from the Google, some of my previous projects and all. So that is the way I am coming with. So I am open to that only. So don't mistake me here. So these are all my own created. So I have gone with some references. Based on that reference only, I'm going to help you to understand the subject. Okay, so here in this SAP WM, so it is just like just I will read the content. Okay, so SAP warehouse management system is provides a flexible automated support in processing all goods movements and in managing stocks in your warehouse complex. So generally in warehouse complex, what you call, so warehouse will have a bigger size, so it will store the goods. It's they are meant for inventory. So in inventory, in the means it's connected with the material management. So where they can bring the stock from the external vendor, they can do the in-house production, and those the points what we are talking here. So in the plus point on the warehouse management, it is the organized way how we are bringing those materials into racks, sections. We can easily identify the material in a warehouse where I can pick the material, I can pack the material, I can issue the things to the relevant customer based on the picking strategies, how I used. So that is the concept of warehouse management in overall. So in warehouse management, so it is a kind of system support scheduled and efficient processing of all logistic process within your warehouse. So it will just like organized way, just I explained you. So it is an organized way of managing the materials. So it's a managing the inventories or stocks, what you can say here. So generally in warehouse, so we can see the two types of warehouse. One is lean warehouse and another one is a full WM. So full warehouse, what we are going to discuss in this class, just lean warehouse is a add-on functionality on inventory management, but it is a behaves as a additional warehouse number in the system, but it will behave as a normal standard storage location, how it works in the SAP MM. So that is the functionality. Here only thing is we can bring the transfer order and we can do the picking, but is basically it is the simplest form of warehouse management. Just like I can tell you a few of the example where this lean warehouse management will come into picture. So if you have a unique product, let's say if you want to implement the warehouse where it's in the gas godowns, like either Indian, HP or Bharat Gas. So that kind of companies, they will go for the lean warehouse management because their product may be one or two, maximum 10. I don't say it is more than 100 or different. If you talk about the opposite way, full warehouse, if I talk about the retail industry sector, if you talk about the chemical industry sector, if you talk about pharmaceutical industry sector, those people will go for the full warehouse concept because their products are minute and vast range of products they are managing in the warehouse. So that's the reason they will bring the put up the racks, sections, and they will maintain the proper warehouse layouts, inbound, outbound, and all. But if you talk about the lean warehouse, so it is a just like it is a basic storage location managed warehouses. It doesn't have any additional functionality like I can implement the RF device. That is not possible in lean WM. I can do the packaging, that is fine. It is just like how you are doing the inbound delivery as well as outbound delivery. That functionality I can, as it is like a standard SAP SDMM functionality, that is works with a lean WM. But difference is full WM, it is a vast because you can bring up with multiple warehouse flavors into the system. So is that clear in the concept of warehouse types? Any questions here, guys?
Yes, it is clear.
Okay, so just it is a basically lean WM is the simplest form, and it is only talks with your storage location with MM and WM, and it will handle within the inventory, because it is just for, I can give a simple example is the gas godowns, like HP or Indian, this kind of gas cylinders, how they are managing the inventory. For that, it's a lean WM is compatible. Full WM is something is a vast where we can implement for retail industry sectors, where they are doing the trading, where they're for the chemical industry sectors, like you can say, even though beverages industries, you can talk about automobile industry, you can talk about manufacturing industry, all people comes under the full warehouse. So this is the difference. So if you jump to another one, so these are all few warehouse features. So this is the standard SAP. I taken this picture from help.sap.com. So this is the warehouse features, why what we say here. So they provided us, the first part is a storage bin management. So how this storage bins are managed in the warehouse? One question. So I can maintain the storage bins in lean WM as well. So system will not stop me to do that. Okay, but only thing is in lean WM, it is a fixed bin concept. Whereas in full WM, it is a dynamic one. Dynamic in the sense, if a bin is empty, system will suggest me which material I have to go and place there. It is a system guided bin determination. So what we call here. So that is called comes under bin management. Second one is a planning and monitoring. So planning and monitoring means I can plan for my goods receipt like inbounds, and same way I can plan for my outbounds in a day. If my warehouse operates in three shifts, so eight hours into three different shifts, so that time I can plan my shipments as well as I can plan my goods receipt. At what time I can go for the goods receipt scenarios, what time I can do my shipment activities, or what time I can do the warehouse cleaning process, like do the internal movements, what are the materials are lying on the floors, I can keep it on the racks, what are the materials are like a physical inventory activities, aging reports. So those things are comes under the planning activities in warehouse, because these are all part of subject, because that is every day happens in warehouse. Whenever a peak period, like a shipment inbound or outbound process, so warehouse people will not focus much on the internal activities. That is what I said, the physical inventory or internal transfer between here and there, like what you call in MM, transfer postings and all. Those activities will be carried out in non-peak hours. That is comes under the planning and monitor. And third part is warehouse movements. So warehouse movements is like just like bringing the material, let's say, any material is to be scrapped. Okay, so this material is shelf life is expired. I need to scrap under some legal conditions, or I need to move this material. I need to do some kitting. Kitting is nothing but, let's say in India, it is a Diwali is coming. I need to provide, let's say it is a retailer. I have to provide like a badam, and I have to put some cashews. I have to make some kismis and all, make a one bunch. So that is kind of warehouse movements. I can club those materials using some different movement types. I can use 309, or in retail industry they will use the 317 and 319 movement types. So they can club it and they can issue to the respective stores. So that kind of activities, even though we can add this physical inventory also part of this warehouse movements, because we can go for the inventory stock checks, countings and all those also comes under the warehouse movements. And this is the radio frequency RF. So radio frequency RFC connection is a one-time activity in the warehouse system, where we can say that it is kind of easier kind of mechanism. So I will tell you the difference why RF people, because if you talk about in warehouse, RF system device is a much complicated, I can say. Why I am telling you this is just I want to clarify that. Why it is complicated, why it is a desktop operation is simple. Desktop operation is like a, just you have to prepare the transfer order, either or goods receipt or goods issue. And you have to take that paper and you have to within a warehouse, you have to walk here and there, and you have to find the bins, and you have to put it in a trolley, and you have to pack it, and that is the manual process. So where it is that user or picker, who is the person is doing this without RF, he has to follow that step. He has to waste the paper, and he has to take the print, and he has to assign it to some pickers, and those people will keep on doing it. This is the efficiency of the picker may not be good. But if you talk about the, if I implement the RF device, so what is the benefits? So in terms of other benefits, disadvantages, first I will tell you what is the disadvantage here. Disadvantages is you have to install that radio frequency tower first. Then you have to integrate with the system. then you have to train your users. If you have to keep the RF devices in charge mode, if it is not charged, means you cannot run the warehouse operations. And another part is you have to do regular software updates in this RF devices. Even though if you fall from that forklift, again this RF device is gone. Minimum cost is 70,000 to 80,000 Indian rupees here. So few of the companies are bringing sophisticated RF devices that will cost up to 2 lakhs to 3 lakh rupees. That is based on the company capacity. So those are all some of the challenges. If someone has theft the device, again it is a big loss to the company. But in that 70,000 rupees, I can bring 4 desktops in my warehouse. So that is also option. So these are the some of the advantages of this one. If you talk about advantages, I can scan the bin. I can go for the exact bin matches based on the verification ID, and I can pick the goods, and or else I can keep the goods in respective storage bin based, during the inbound. And I can, it will give, allow me to scan with a difference of 1 meter in that 70 degree angle. So I can, if you stand in front of the bin, right, I can just bend up to 70 degree so that it will scan in the bottom, and it, I can do that. If I sitting on a forklift, even though if I raise the RF device at 70 degree on top, even though I can scan the RF gun and I can scan the material and I can do the picking and packing process. So those are the some of the advantages and disadvantages there. So I think you are you came to know how this RF functionality. So we will check in the system as well. Okay, now it's concerned the warehouse control. So warehouse controls is just a process of controlling, like what are the in a rack. Let's say I have 5 different materials. Let's say one material is bulk materials, and I want to keep, I mean, bulk materials are not a bigger size, it's a smaller size with the different odd dimensions. So those odd dimension, normally in warehouse all the bin sizes will be 1 meter by 1 meter. So that is a standard size what we are operating in India. So even though that pallets and all, so in warehouse, so that is also standard size is 1 meter by 1 meter. So that is the standard. Okay, so in that way all warehouses bins are maintained. But if you talk about the pharmaceutical industry, if I'm manufacturing a small tablets and all, but in that case it is not worth for me keeping that bigger size and all. So just general ideology on this warehouse control. So there I can maintain the storage sections. So what kind of material has to go in which kind of bin? So that kind of controls I can manage here in this rack. In first rack, I can maintain a bigger size. In second rack, I can go for the smaller quantities according to their weight, width, length, breadth. Those are the volume criteria I can maintain and I can do. These are the some of the parameters. Even though other control parameters, like it will check by the bin capacity checks, it will check by the, you can say, weight parameters, and it will type of material, what type of material you are going to store. I cannot store the ice cream directly on the bin. That is correct. I cannot do that, but I have to keep it in some storage controls, like it has to go under some specific what you call deep freezer. If my industry is like a fish processing industry or meat processing industry, so in that seafoods or meat process, so I cannot keep open like in this. So that way I need to segregate the type of controls that will help me here. So I think friends, any doubts or questions here so that I can jump to the next slide.
We know the you said radio frequency connection, setup cost, everything, difficulties, advantages you just explained. But how different is it from the barcode scanners?
See, radio frequency device, because as I said, its cost start with 60 to 70,000, so it will have the inbuilt features. Even though I can scan my the barcode through smart mobile also, means what if I using the Apple or Android mobiles or Apple phones, so there also I can download the app and I can do the scanning. So that is also help us here to do the scanning. But in RF devices, that is an inbuilt functionality. So that will having a capacity of scanning of 1D or 2D dimensional barcodes, it is having a capacity. It will not scan the QR codes like how we are doing the Paytm QR code scanning. That will not support. So this is the one of the drawback in RF device.
That means Barcode scanning is not possible, this RF device, right?
Barcode scanning is possible 1D and 2D. One dimensional and two dimensional barcode scanning is possible in a RF device.
Okay.
But only thing is this QR codes, what I'm calling. So when I'm going to using a Paytm or PhonePe and all, right? So that's the square kind of things that may not support. Now I don't know, because advanced barcode scanners will do that facility also. But I'm not sure on that. But what are the RF devices or RF guns, what I've handled? So that will support for 1D and 2D barcode scanning. So that is supporting. Most of the industry sector will go for the 2D barcode scanning. So that is the comfortable for the developer as well to bring print that barcode, as well as the user also. It is very easy, and we can clearly identify. So how to do this thing? If you want to know more thing, means then as a part of a subject, that barcode we can do scan using this RF device, Srinivas.
Okay, go ahead. Thank you.
Okay. You stop me, okay, if you have any doubts or something, so that I can explain there, and I can jump to the next slide. Okay, so coming to the next slide, so it is a warehouse process map. So how this warehouse will be supporting for other models of SAP? It's a pure kind of technical. So just it is a standard I have taken from a standard SAP flowchart diagram, how this will work. So here in the warehouse, this is a warehouse. It is, I think, assume this is a central warehouse. One point I missed you here. So just I've explained to lean WM and full WM. But in SAP WM, we can make it as a standalone system. Standalone system is nothing but, let's say, my company or my business or my organization operating entire ERP software on Oracle or Microsoft Dynamics or some other tool. But they were only interested in the SAP WM. Yes, this can be work as a standalone system. I can able to connect with that. So that is also possibility is there. Okay, so this is the one point just I missed there in the first beginning of the session. So just I'm adding that. So please, you can note that point as well. So we can work as a standalone system. So that time it will become a decentralized system. Decentralized means it is a standalone. If it is centralized, that is a within ERP system, means within SAP system. So that way we can we can run a business in that way. Okay, if we talk about in within SAP, so within SAP, this warehouse,
what is the difference between centralized and decentralized?
Centralized is within SAP. Okay. It is a centralized means within SAP, it is supporting, because what is the process map I'm showing, it is a centralized one. If it is a decentralized, so it is a standalone system, because just now I explained you, standalone system is a decentralized system where my organization or my business or my company is operating ERP tool with a different, either Oracle or either they are using Microsoft Dynamics or they are using BAN or some other ERP tool, but they are only interested on SAP WM. They are not interested on any other models of SAP. In that case, this particular decentralized warehouse WM, that particular SAP WM is called decentralized warehouse WM here. Clear?
Okay.
So I think you guys are know the SAP process. I think this warehouse management is supporting with the sales and distribution. Then it is supports with RF devices, it supports with the quality management, it will supports with the production supply, and it is inventory management. So these are the areas it will support. So I think production supply, I think both of you guys are expert in the subjects. I no need to explain many things about this, because I'm not a production planning consultant. So if I something I'm telling wrong, just you correct me. So it is a thing I am saying about the quality management. I know a bit of the quality management, how that work in the system side, but I will tell you how this in SAP WM, how it works, and how we are going to see the stock status, stock checks, and as well as this remote device, we will explain, we can discuss how this, tower or mobile device, how we can integrate and all. This is the sales and distribution. So it is specifically used for outbound process. And inventory management is meant for the external procurement as well as in-house procurement. If it was the in-house procurement, so it will directly come from production supply and finished goods, and that will store in the warehouse. If it is inventory management, so I can check with the external vendor also. That is also I can store in the warehouse. So this is the overall process map here. So just it is the some contents. What are the functions I can run in warehouse? Well, that is one is inbound. So generally in warehouse functions, they are categorized in high level as the three levels. One is inbound functionality, and another is outbound, and third one is internal movements. Okay, so if someone asks what are the warehouse functionalities, that time you have to tell the three functionalities. One is inbound, outbound, and internal movements. This is the high level functionalities you can directly tell to them. If anyone asks what are the warehouse, three things: inbound, outbound, and internal movements. If you talk about in coming to the inbound, so there is a two different functionalities. One is IM before WM and WM before IM. So it looks like a straightforward. So what is IM before WM and WM before IM? So just I want to highlight you, IM means inventory management and WM is warehouse management. So IM before WM means first I will do the goods receipt, then I will park the materials into storage bins through WM concept. So that bin function. If it is WM before IM, first I will do the binning first, means I will store the materials into bin, then I will do the goods register. So this is the two ways I can differentiate in inbound and outbound. So same way, if I go to the outbound, so that is the one standard processing of the delivery. So this is a simple process. Another process is I can go with the two-step picking process. So two-step picking process is I will consolidate group of deliveries with different customer orders, either sales order or stock transfer or anything, and I will pick together. I'll put it into staging area. From there I'm going to distribute. So that is the two step. Here what happens, that the consolidated picking happens one time and I will put it in the staging area. From there I'm going to distribute according to the customer orders. That is called a two step picking in the outbound process. If you talk about the internal process, so these two things, it is an everyday task, that is inbound and outbound. So that is they will have some specific times for the inbound and they will do the outbound for the specific times based on the traffics and so many things they will consider. Because when I see in a warehouse, right, people will think about this. People will say that this time traffic is too much, police will not allow, they will not allow to come into the city, they will put a fine, so many things they will talk. So I seen that. So that's the reason they made some specific time zones for this inbound as well as outbound scenarios. Probably if you talk about in the Delhi and Chennai regions, most of the time they will issue the goods to their customer after 5:30 only, because in morning 10:30 to 5:30 the city will not, mean city traffic police will not allow the trucks to enter to the city. They will put a fine and all. So in that case they will issue the goods to the customer after evening 5:30. So that is the time slot what they made. Till late night 10-11, like that, they are continuously they are doing the goods issue. Same way they will receive the goods in early morning, maybe 5:30 to they will, before 10:30 they will do the inbound process. So normally in between what they will do, they will get the orders and they will operate this internal warehouse process like a bin to bin transfers, replenishments. Maybe in noon time, maybe 2:30, 3 o'clock, they will start with doing the picking process and they will keep ready and they will load the truck. And after 5:30 they will ask them to leave the premises for the outbound. And same way inbound, so they will ask the truck driver stand in queue and they will do the goods receipt process till 11 or 12. In between 2 hours they will start the other process. Whenever that is no peak hour, so there is nothing to do and all, that time they will process with this internal warehouse process. Internal warehouse process is all like a bin to bin transfer. It is like a manual processing. And that is another process is called replenishment. Let's say if today is in too much inbound and my entire racks got filled and some of the products or that boxes are lying on warehouse floors. So even though I cannot pass my forklift or trolley inside, that time what happens, this is overflow. Once it is in noon time, that outbound happens, most of the racks got emptied. That time I have to run the replenishment so that what are the boxes are lying or cases lying on the floor, I can pick up the box and I have to put it into the storage rack. So that is called a replenishment process. It is from open ground to racks. So that process it will they will do. It means that is the runs in the replenishment scenarios. So another is the physical inventory process. So physical inventory process, especially is kind of mishandling defects, theft, lost and found. So many things are there as a part of physical inventory process that will be there taking care in the internal warehouse process. And talking about integration with other modules, is there any, like, let's say I am an MM consultant, I did one 311 movement type, and automatically it indirectly created the TR. So warehouse manager has to check, okay, these people did, because they from the head office or someone has did. So I have to process that transfer requirements. So those things, even though if it's something I need to material, is I did the PGI, another guy has canceled the billing document and reversed the goods issue, that time I have to run the integration. So what is that? GR has been done, so it has to reverse. I have to reverse and I have to put into the return stock. Those are all some of the return processes, as well as cancellation, transfer postings and all. So that will come under the internal warehouse process. Okay, so in next coming to this RF device integration. So RF device integration is supports for all kind of business requirements, like inbound, outbound and internal. Even though we can see some of the stock checks transactions also available through that RF device, it is a small device, so that we can see through that. So this is the same way how our desktop works, same way this RF device also behaves in the same way. But one thing, RF device will not support the creation of delivery or PJ and all, it will not do. It will only do some set of warehouse transactions, not all. So keep that thing in your mind. Okay, any questions?
Yeah, we know. In the inbound, you said IM before WM. Second is WM before IM. What I did not get that.
See, IM is inventory management. Okay. IM is inventory management and WM is warehouse management. First is IM before WM is inventory management before warehouse management. Inventory management means simple process. You know, purchase order, and then I will do goods receipt using MIGO. Okay, then 101 happens, and that material, what are the goods I have received, so I need to put it into bins. So there I have to call the WM functions. So that WM functions I have to use means I have to, that particular material document will create the transfer requirement. That transfer requirement you need to convert into transfer order so that I can keep those materials into bins. So that is the process. So another process is, first I will keep those material into bin, then I will do the goods receipt. So that is WM before IM.
Okay. Here, that means either of the process will be implemented or both will be implemented.
See, that depends. Okay, let's say I can give the example. So why this will be there, why will not be? Few companies can implement both. Let's say if I'm doing this inbound process, I am doing the ASN, what you call advanced shipping notifications. Okay. Let's say my organization is import. They are doing the import vendoring. So that time ASN will come into picture. That time they will do first what you call WM, and later they will do the IM. If some is a local procurement, then I will go for the IM first, and they will do later. I will do the WM. So both things will possible.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, coming to the org structure, this is the standard org structure of SAP is provided. So I think you guys know about company code, and it will have two plants. Assume that one plant is having store location. One thing is I want to highlight here is I can assign one store location can have only one warehouse number. I cannot assign multiple warehouse number into the system for one store location. But other way, but one warehouse number can be assigned to multiple storage locations. So this combination is possible. Okay, this is one of the important thing. And if you talk about the structure, so it is linked with the warehouse number is linked with store location. Just I'm talking about the SAP standard WM org structure. So it is linked with the store location, and same way it is linked with the storage type. Here storage type will play the major role. So I think in the upcoming classes, just I will tell you what are the control parameters of storage types. So it is kind of heart of warehouse WM. So most of the controls you can do it through a storage type. So that is one of the, if you understood the storage type concept clearly, so you can you will understand how the system behavior on the business scenarios.
Okay, where the bin, Vinod, where the bin will come here?
Sorry, I think I storage section. Oh, sorry, I missed the bin. It should be come between after storage section and bin and quant. Sorry, I missed that particular box. Sorry, I need to amend this. Sorry, I missed that. good catch. Okay, I will update it. Okay, so here bin will come after storage.
No, I don't think this is a catch. Yeah,
we were talking
just now bin to bin transfer is one of the process, right? So we are not showing
correct,
the thing
correct,
at all.
But in this picture means when I am doing this manual editing, right? So I didn't notice that. Okay, just I have captured and all. And just the important thing is storage type is just I have explained to you about storage sections. Okay, I will update. Sorry for that, but it is a miss from my side. Okay, so it is a manual error. It is not an intentional one, but
you are also saying that a storage location, one storage location can have only one warehouse.
Correct. But warehouse can have multiple storage location. Means it can be linked with multiple storage location of different plants.
Different plants.
Yes. Okay. In my warehouse, I can run. Let's say I'm running a 3PL, like a third party logistics. Okay, so that particular customer means but particular 3PL can handle multiple customers' products in that warehouse. That is possible. So same way it is also supporting in that way. Okay, then coming to the store.
I just would like to add to Srini's question. So Srini, if you look at here under plan 2 storage location, one is assigned to one warehouse number, right? So if you have the same warehouse to be used for plant one also, you can assign. But
the same
storage location one, plant two storage location one cannot be assigned to more than one warehouse number. Warehouse number assigned to another storage location of another plant or same plant.
Correct.
That makes sense.
So it is storage location is only linked with one warehouse number, but warehouse number can be linked with multiple S-locks. In that way, you can keep the things because it's kind of a confusion. I understand the points you are saying, but when we are starting stage,
as a thumb rule, per plant, per storage location, one warehouse.
Correct.
In the combination of plant and storage location, should be one.
Yes,
that is the fundamental.
Correct, that is the architecture.
Correct.
So because when we are in the subject, right, so we should understand the architecture, not only the process. So why SAP is designed like that, so those things we need to think also, because it's a worldwide accepted system, right? So they are taught all this process and concepts, so we need to just understand how he made, why he made and all. So there we will understand, okay, why this is the reason and all. So if you think with the practical examples, then we can clearly make the subject with the concrete structure here. Okay, so next is the storage section. It is just like I can, which section I can keep the material and all. So that I think I have updated. And last one is the storage bin is there. Sorry, I missed that. And the storage bin is just like I can keep the materials into warehouse. And last one is the quant. So quant is nothing but is the last, it's the organizational warehouse unit. This is the last unit. It will create at the time of goods issue, or not creates, but it will create the time of goods receipt. So if I do a transfer posting from here to there and all, so if it is material is accommodating or getting the new place, there that quant will create. It's a dynamic creation, and it will help us to do some of the other business process like internal warehouse movements. It will identify first in, first out, last in, first out, batch expiry, so many other parameters it will holds in that particular table. So I will explain you in detail. So maybe just I'm going to give a high level picture of this. WM configuration overview. So these are all things what we are going to cover. So just it is a high level, okay? So don't means don't get into this only this subject. So just we will say that these are the high level I'm saying. So we are going to define the warehouse, we are going to define the storage type and their control parameters, and we'll define the put away as well as picking strategies, and storage type search, section type search, storage unit type search, bin structures, how the bin structure to be determined, and how this integration will happen between SD, IAM, PP and QM models, how to set up this warehouse activity monitor using that variants and all. So those are the things, because high level, okay? So just it is the high level picture what I'm trying to say here. And here few of the master data is talks about, just I'm going to, I'm not going to take it more, another 10 minutes I need to close because I need to jump to my project calls. Sorry for that. So just we are end up with a few say, decks, few slides. And in WM master data, I'm going to tell you about how the storage bins and storage type levels. So what are the levels means? One is that particular warehouse will have some control parameters. Okay, so in terms of weight, width, volume and all. So that parameters, how that particular storage bin will accommodate. And similar way at storage type level. So I have also maintained some storage type level control parameters. So how this both things will combining together and it will give me the better results while I'm keeping the material inside the bin. So this is the points I'm going to explain about you in our classes. And these are all process controls, process management control. So how this internal documents, like if you're you know an MM, like how you create the purchase info records and all, those things, some of the basic internal documents are able to create. So those kind of documents like transfer requirements and posting change notices. And next is for the picking purpose, this transfer orders. So how this will operate inside the systems. So these things we are going to discuss. So maybe we'll go to this further this thing. So in transfer order, I will say that how this transfer order is supporting, what are the processes I can adopt to generate or create a transfer order. So these processes we are going to discuss, like how we can do the manual TR, posting changing notifications. Posting change notification is like just it is an internal adjustment. If I do the transfer posting, right, that time it will create the posting changes. It is especially for your quality stock to unrestricted stock, unrestricted to block stock, that kind of situation, PCN will get update. So these are the processes we are going to discuss. And automatic transfer, these are all system terms, okay? So I'm not taking any layman language terms. These are all system terminologies of SAP. And automatic TR to TO creations and manual processing, how to do this manual processing and all. And coming to this SAP WM report, just you put the one question. So SAP WM reports and all. So what are the reports is available standard? So we can go into the system and we can check few more reports also. Just standard business requirement, how the people are using these reports, like empty bin reports, posting change notices, open all transfer orders, then warehouse activity monitor, then bin status reports, stock reports like LS24 or LS26, those transaction codes also I will going to show you. And also meanwhile, we can also find out some more reports, which is like a shelf life expiry date check using LX27, whether is shipment monitors like VL060, how this will behaves and all. So those things also we can check in the WM report side.
Yeah, okay. Vinod, there is a, actually you forgotten integration with the batch management. I think you should include there.
Yeah, when we are taking discussing in our session, right? It is a high level program because it is not a last class. So we will come up with all the possible scenarios like batch management, SLED, and how the first in first out. So those kind of scenarios we will test it there, and we will I'll make sure that how the system performance, how the system behavior will work, how the reporting will run there. So those things we will discuss, Srinivas. Okay, coming to the this thing, this I think this is the last slide. So in this last slide, just I'm going to the high level difference of WM and EWM. So in WM, we can say that it is a simple warehouse process. So it is a kind of a flexible warehouse. So you know the ECC, how this works. So same way WM is also support for simple warehouse process, I can say here. So it will be flexible for all industry sector, Verosa, irrespective of your industry sector, it will support for all the processes in WM, in standard WM. If you, second point is easy to understand. So it is not, it will not take much time to understand the process. It's just like you need to, thing is the multiple operations are more like TR to TO creation, then transfer order confirmation. So those processes are more here. Okay, those, but if you, once you understand, right, so you feel like comfortable to understand the subject. And here also a few transaction codes. You have minimal transaction, not more than 20 or 25, I can say. If you add the reports and all, maximum 30, I can say. Within less than 30 also, you can operate the scenarios. And all the transaction code, maximum 4 digits transaction codes, what we say here. So if you talk about EWM and all, so it is a WM is a basic one, EWM is an advanced one, so that way. So in EWM process, it is a kind of a complex warehouse process, and they will bring a lot of WM functions like consolidations, deconsolidations, kittings, VAS, slotting and rearrangement process. And if you talk about physical inventory, there is also multiple processes they are added there. So these are in complex warehouse structure there. So even in the SAP EWM, it is like we can build as a standalone system because you need to integrate with ECC to EWM system. That is nowadays what happens if S4HANA has come. So they made a inbuilt in one system. So that is the one of the advantage. If you guys are using S4HANA, so you no need to worry about the standalone and all. But even though some basic data transfer and all you have to do, that core interfaces and all in terms of WM and EWM, that is you have to do. But you have to create the WM, full WM number also inside the system as a part of configuration activity in WM. But here the challenge is whenever you make a mistake, right? So in EWM, it's quite difficult to reverse because it has to connecting between ECC and EWM. So if something is a data transfer fail or something core interfaces fail or someone has edited or amended it in ECC, again that data will be in transit only. So you cannot reprocess and all. So again, it is a biggest challenge in EWM. So that's why I mentioned this difficult on manual herring. So sometimes it is very complex or it is not easy to understand. If you talk about the consolidation, deconsolidation, sometimes you will say that handling unit is mandatory for that. So in that consolidation and deconsolidation, you have to pack that product, you have to do this, you have to bring the packaging material in the both the system. If packaging material is not aligned with ECC, again it will fail. So those many things you have to take care before running the scenario. So this is a kind of not so easy to understand, but in WM it is a quite easy and simpler way we can make the subject and processes are clear. So these are all differences. So you want to know any additional on this or? Hello?
I think this is more or less covering everything, you know, but can we also include like cross docking if it is possible? Cross docking and handling management.
Handling management, I can, but cross docking, if you talk about yard management, I am not going to cover in the subject. I'm sorry to say that. If you talk about the TRM and all, those things are separate, I can say, but only simply simpler because I'm not going to just, I can explain what this cross docking will work, but I cannot show you in the system how this will work or be. So there is some other changes, settings are also required, but as per the timelines and given, so those things at present, it is not in my hand to deliver that object.
Okay. No problem. So handling okay. management.
I can give you just a theoretical knowledge, but I'm not promising you that I can show you a system and I can give a demo on that. So don't okay. keep that expectation. So just I can give the theoretical knowledge on that, how this cross-docking flow through will work. Because I worked on this retail environment, cross-docking flow through. There is some other pain points also there. So that is, I will explain in the call. But in as a demo systems, it's not easy to demonstrate all those processes.
Understood.
Okay. So this is my end of the deck. I think you have any questions, please shoot to me or else we can discuss further with Ruchika and she will be the facilitator and coordinator between me and you guys. so that anything, if we can reach out to her and you can give my good or bad feedback, whatever you feel. So I'm not saying that you have to give the 10 out of 10 or something. So you have to give your best feedback. That is what I can assure. So if you're happy with my session or if you're happy with my knowledge, then we can proceed. So that's the, it is an opportunity for me. So open to tell you all of you. So I will do my best and I can give my best talent and I can provide my best knowledge to you guys.
That's great. Yeah. Okay. So on lighter note, EWM is not easy to understand and all by the consultant itself. Then I am always wondering why SAP has developed that product for the.
If you want to talk about, because I will tell you, even though I worked on the EWM in and out, okay. So you know the consultant, so I don't want to discriminate between this consultant, because there are many people in the market, they only few of the seniors they know, they will put it as a VWM consultant. But the subject is quite complicated, but people will say that just when they do one good service process, they will say that I'm a VWM consultant. I don't want to expect to be like that. Okay, if you run me one production planning order and processing and you go with the work scheduling and all, I can say I'm also PP consultant, but that is not a case. But I don't want to take you in that way. So I have to be thorough understanding of the subject, then only I will pitch into this activity. Even though I did two implementation on EWM, but I say that it is not so easy. Even though few of the concepts, I'm not clear with that.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. So I seen the who are all the expert in the subject, even though they will struggle to in the product masters, business partners maintaining, even though they don't understand where the SIP is failing, why it is happening and all. So those things are challenges I've seen in person. So that's why, even though I'm not saying a master in the subject, but I've seen the pain points and challenges. So that's why I'm highlighting you. Because few of the drivers are experts on the roads, but unless and until I know the condition of the road, then I will say, okay, there is a turn, there is a pit pots, I need to take down my vehicle slow, or else I may skid. So those things I need to take care, even though I might be expert driver. So this is the point I want to highlight in a practical way. Okay, so don't take in another way. So
no, that's correct. Absolutely.
It is not, doesn't mean that I given a license, because I'm an RTO officer, given a license by taking the make a 8 or reverse the gear and all. It is I'm not an expert, so that I have to think of the other condition of the road as well, right? If I come to bought my car and road and I think all these things. So these are the few of the challenges, because I will in the next sessions, I will tell you. So because I want to discuss this point. So initially my introduction, I told you guys, it is not, don't consider this a training. It is a mutual discussion between me and you. Some of the points I need to understand from you, and some of the points I am going to give best knowledge of mine. So that is the way what I come into the picture here. Okay.
What is the system you are going to use? SAP, which version?
I think you have to talk to Ruchika. She is the right person.
Vinod sir will be using ECC system, na? That's what they are asking. ECC system, right?
I will be using ECC system only. I said the ECC system is the compatible, but version would be ECC 6.0 above is good for us, not below that one. So it is quite compatible to run the scenarios.
Vinod, one more question.
0.0 is used generally. Yeah, please sir.
Yeah, one more question. Do you have any comparison things between HANA and ECC 6.0 for WM point of view?
If you talk about the HANA system, because at present I'm working on HANA only, so I want to tell you on that. But HANA system is more about your color, not on the, because you can see the few of the transaction codes they changed here in the system. But if you compare to your more attractive on colors, then go for HANA. But even though all functional, 99% of the functionalities they are mapped from ECC to HANA. Only thing is that what you call in here R3, right? There might be this R2, because they are deactivated at Oracle and they bought this SAP HANA Studio. That is only the plus point. Even though that table extract and all, that is completely faster than this.
Can you also include a couple of slides?
This we can do, but my question is based on your feedback and all, so that if you jump to the next discussion, then we will surely add those slides and I can share it to you.
No. Feedback means for this demo?
Yeah, just I want to get the demo and I can talk with Ruchika later. No, not in hurry. So you can take your time and you can give your feedback
that
about
means,
me.
That means, you know, this is not starting session. It's only demo.
It is just a demo. It's a high level demo. So because it is the interaction between you and me, and just we have to understand each other, and just I want to sell my knowledge in front of you. So that is a demo what we are proposed in this class.
Srinivas sir, as I understand from Jagdish sir, we were looking at ECC WM training. HANA was not included as a part of the curriculum expectation.
Ruchika,
so if you need to revise on that.
We are not expecting HANA training. Okay
sir.
We want to know the differences now he has given between EWM. Okay, like that, you know, maybe a couple of slides. We are not expecting any training of HANA.
Sure, sir. So, Vinod, sir, feedback here comes that we have to add a few slides to understand the difference between ECC and HANA, basically. That's all. Practical configurations we are not covering on HANA, because anyways, we have to
balance. That's fine, because maybe in upcoming classes, right, when we are directly jumping into the system, there.
Absolutely.
And then we can amend the deck and we can share it. Maybe I don't have any problem to amend it now, but maybe getting the good feedback and all, so then we can amend and we can share it to you.
So Srinivas sir, just for your information, this is just a demo. We have not yet begun the training. Things have not been closed by.
Okay. You yourself and Jagdish will decide on the starting date.
Yes, sir. Based on your feedback, as again and again, you know, Vinod sir is mentioning, and based on, you know, when you want to begin, we are completely flexible to start immediately as well. I mean, depends on you.
Okay. Venkat, I think we can discuss among ourselves and then can give the feedback, right, Venkat?
Yes, Srini, we can.
Okay, Ruchika, thank you, Vinod.
Thank you so much, Srinivas sir. Thank you, Venkat sir, and thanks so much, Vinod, for, you know, sparing the time for everybody, rather. And Mr. Naveen also, probably we could not have really answered much of your queries, Naveen, because you probably joined in late, right? Anytime, any query, any concern, do feel free to, you know, kind of contact us. We don't mind getting, you know, things sorted before we proceed forward. Right, sir?
Yeah, sure.
Please, sir. Anything else from anyone, or can we just hang up?
Yeah, we can.
Thank you so much, Ruchika and Vinod, for arranging this session. Thank you so much for your time.